Right, so how are we doing on time? We're right on 15 minutes. We have a lot to cover, so I'm going to speed up a little bit, and we have time to answer questions at the end. So, engineering validation test. After you have samples, it's time to validate everything. We call it EVT stage, and typically you either use your existing prototypes or you run a new set of prototyping. The core question you need to answer here is, does the product cover the functionality described in a product specification? Typical tests to run, functional tests, power, thermal, and EMI. So you get the final boards. They're going to be look something like this. You do functional tests. Functional tests are how device powers up, is all communication working, what's the power draw. So really the core functionality for the device is being tested here. If device has wireless connectivity, you test RSSI, you test the range for communication, and you what we recommend doing is test how many devices can be working simultaneously in the same room. For example, Bluetooth has limitation of about 5 devices, so it's really important to know what you're dealing with once you have wireless connectivity. Another trick, another recommendation we have is to use thermal cameras a lot. The cooler your product runs, the more reliable it's going to be. So we do thermal analysis both on the PCBs and on a product. We see which part of design get hot and we work from there. The cooler device runs, the more stable it's going to operate. So really invest time in this testing here. You lock components. There is no significant change of components after EVT. If needed, you go another iteration here, but don't plan to change it later on. When you start working with SCM, they're not going to accept much of the changes later on. So really lock your component database here.